Hi everybody, it's me, Joe Dick, Coding Maniac, and in today's video I'll show you 5 measures of quality for your classification model. We will use the model from the last video about sentiment analysis as a reference in this video. So, if you haven't watched the video yet, although it's not necessary to follow along with this one, now would be a good time to have a look at it. So, now let's dive in. If you watched the video about sentiment analysis, you already have seen one measure technique for classification models. This measure is called accuracy and is calculated like the number of right predictions divided by all samples. You can see this being made here. As you see, we have an accuracy of 49%, but is this any good? To answer that, let's have a look at the test dataset, since this is the dataset with which we will evaluate our model. I will paste some code in. All right. As we see, the data is not balanced. There are much more positive observations than negative. So there is one clear majority class in this case, it's the class positive reviews. This tells us that if we would simply always predict every review as a positive, our accuracy would be equal to the majority class, which is 80%. This means that our classification model should always beat the majority class, else it would be better just to assume a prediction that is in the majority class. So, with our accuracy of 94%, we beat the majority class, which is a good thing. Our model is better than always predicting positive reviews. Yay! It is a thing, right? So, the next measure I would like to show is called the confusion matrix. There is a built-in method in Scikit to generate a confusion matrix. I'll just paste the code real quick. So, this is how it looks like. I added some comments from the documentation to show you what those numbers mean. I also prepared a better representation of these numbers to have something to talk about. So, as you see, across the top there are the observation class labels, and down the side there are the prediction labels. Each prediction of our model does fall in one of those 4 categories. True positives, that means it is a positive review and also was predicted as a positive. A false positive, that stands for a negative review that was falsely predicted as a positive. A false negative is a positive review that was predicted as a negative, and a true negative means a negative review which was correctly identified and predicted as a negative review. Depending on the problem you are working on, it is possible that one of those false positives or false negatives has a higher cost and should be considered more harmful for the model than the other, and those needs to be minimized. A common example for this is when you try to predict whether someone has cancer. In this case, false negatives would mean that you tell someone he is healthy and no further treatment is needed, but in reality, this is not true. A false positive in this case wouldn't be that bad. You would tell someone that he has cancer, which might be a shock for this person, but chances are high that during the further procedure, it will become clear that this is not the case and the person is healthy. So, in the cancer prediction case, you should really try to minimize false negatives. A confusion matrix can help you to evaluate such things. The next measure I want to talk about is called precision. I will again paste some code in. So, the precision of our model is almost 95%. So, how is the precision calculated? The precision is calculated as the count of true positives divided by the true positives plus the false positives. If we have a look at this in the confusion matrix, we will see that the precision is true positive and false positive. So, it's the true positives divided by the true positives and the false positives. So the precision is calculated with those fields. And the precision basically tells you how precise is my prediction of positive values. And the low precision indicates many false positives. Another measure I want to talk about is called the recall. I will again paste some code in. So our model has a recall of 98%. The recall is calculated as the count of true positives divided by the true positives plus the false negatives. If we have a look at our confusion matrix, you will see that the recall is calculated by the count of true positives divided by the true positives and the false negatives. So it's calculated with this column. What a recall means is it's basically how many percent of the observed positives were correctly predicted. This is also called the true positive rate. A low recall indicates many false negatives. The last measure of quality I want to cover is called the F1 score. I'll paste some code. So our model has an F1 score of 96%. The F1 score is calculated as following. So the F1 score is calculated as the precision times the recall divided by the precision plus the recall times 2, and is basically a weighted average of the precision and the recall.
So when evaluating your classification model, you shouldn't only count on accuracy, but also check the other measures. There are situations in which you really want to avoid one error more than the other, like in the cancer example. If you liked the video, please subscribe and leave a comment. And also please follow me on the other social networks to be the first to get updates about new content. Bye and see you next time.